Ms. Fells had come to the emergency room at the UF Health Jacksonville and had obtained imaging or pictures of her brain, which demonstrated her brain tumor. And she was then admitted to the ICU service or the intensive care for close monitoring. And that is when they consulted me to help with her brain tumor. I met with her in the ICU and I demonstrated to her what the problem was, which was a large tumor. And I explained that her symptoms of headaches and trouble walking was due to this tumor.
He discovered that it was only one other person had that type of tumor that I had, and they were over in Europe. And so it was a unique tumor, and because of the location of the tumor.
And then we sat down and discussed what we thought this tumor was as best we could in terms of the differential diagnosis. And then we spent time talking about the complexity of this tumor and how the likelihood of a complication was relatively high, and that our job as the team of skull-based surgeons were to reduce those risks as much as we could to get her through the surgery safely.
He told me that he was going to research, and he had a team to a team of doctors that they worked together and to come up with the diagnosis and everything. And so they really gave me a lot of confidence. You know, it just wasn't one doctor, it was just a whole team that decides on, what was to be done.
The planning phase was extensive. We wanted to do nothing but short of a perfect surgery for her. And to do that required a lot of preparation. So Ms. Fells' surgery was very complex, and it required a significant amount of expertise that I find that is only available at academic institutions. We have anesthesiologists that are dedicated to neurology or neuroanesthesiologists, and then we have an excellent group of OR nursing staff and technicians who know how to perform these surgeries with us as a team member. And during Ms. Fells' surgery, there was actually three different surgeons involved. Myself, who was there from beginning to end, Dr. Brzezicki, who was there for the beginning of the surgery, who helped us dissect the vein or our vessel off of the tumor. And then after that was completed, Dr. Ramathula and I, together under a microscope, took the tumor out while trying to, and did, preserve the brain. One of the fundamentals of neurosurgery and probably surgery in general is that it doesn't end when the wound is closed. The patient care continues afterwards.
When I came out of surgery, the first thing when they were putting me on the bed, I was ice cold, you know, and I was kept saying, I'm cold, I'm cold, I'm cold. I remember them putting blankets on me, hot blankets, and then finally putting like 10 blankets on me. And finally I got kind of warm and they were really, really nice and really good to me. I said they treated me like I was a queen when I was in the hospital. I was there a month, and all that time they treated me like I was a queen. I mean, I enjoyed it. I did. They treated me so good.
The first 24 hours after brain surgery are absolutely critical. When the tumor is removed, there is a crater where the tumor used to be, and the surrounding brain is fragile. And I'm glad to say that Ms. Fells' surgery was successful in that after the tumor was out, she did not have a post-op complication such as a bleed within the cavity.
This is where I come for everything now. You know, I'm in good shape compared to, what could have happened. I think about what could have happened and what didn't happen, you know, and how I am, how I recovered. You know, because I could have had a stroke or, you know, anything, you know, but I'm in good shape. I got more sense now than I did before I had the surgery.
Obviously, we're incredibly excited and happy that Ms. Fells had a good outcome from her brain tumor surgery. We're incredibly privileged to be able to help patients with brain tumors in this region. And without the investment in the skull-based center, we would be unable to help patients like Ms. Fells, who have very complicated brain tumors and have very limited options of receiving excellent care like we provide here.